Hey guys, Anthony here, and welcome to Quick Shot. Guess what? A whole bunch of games were announced. Well, not a whole bunch, but really just two of note. So we're going to talk about them really quick because I didn't really have enough to say about both games to make their own videos. So we're going to talk about the two here. So let's start with Resident Evil. It has finally happened. The games industry is now imploding onto itself, into itself. Resident Evil is getting a remake of the remake of Resident Evil. Whoa, what is this? Now, it's not unheard of that there's a remake of a remake of a remake, but it's very rare. You know, Resident Evil set off the horror game genre, and then they remade Resident Evil for the GameCube, and I think it also came out for the Wii later on, and that game was great. I mean, it looked amazing for the time, for the GameCube. I bought a GameCube like a year ago just to play all the Resident Evils. Resident Evil 0, picked up 4 again, just because I wanted to play them on there. They were still impressive the day I bought them a year ago. Still looked good. So now they're taking the remade Resident Evil and remaking it again for Xbox 360, PS3, PS4, Xbox One, and PC. Sorry, Wii U. Capcom doesn't love you, I'm sorry. So yeah, a few days ago it leaked. Yeah, it leaked.
Oh boy, I sure hope our new game doesn't leak before it's ready. Oh no! I sent it to everybody in the game industry!
Alright, and that's interesting. I'm glad to see this. There's a few things of note. You know, they said they're improving the graphics, obviously, sound quality. What they did say was that they're gonna have two options for controls. You can either play with the original tank controls, which, you know, the series was known for, that really stiff. But that control scheme added to the game, I think, the way they wanted you to feel. You could pick between the tank controls and Resident Evil 4 style controls over the shoulder, which is cool. I would play through the game twice just to see it from that angle and then that angle. And what that tells me also is that the backgrounds are no longer pre-rendered. The way the GameCube made it look so good was that the backgrounds were all completely pre-rendered. It wasn't being handled by the GameCube. But now, it's weird because pre-rendered back then is live rendered now. One thing I'm hoping for this is it's like a feel of the waters for Capcom. They're feeling, I wonder if people are still interested in that style of game and that horror game. Let's put out this remake and see if people buy it. And maybe if they like it, we'll continue making Resident Evil games like that instead of the action schlock shit they've made now. Then the second game that was announced is another Assassin's Creed game. Yay! Assassin's Creed Rogue for the Xbox 360 and the PS3. And because of that fact, I'm surprised people are making such a big deal about this game. It's obviously just the quickly thrown together version for the last gen to make a quick buck. But anyways, you play as Shay, some guy who was an assassin, but now he's an assassin hunter. Ooh. And he has a ship. So they're taking the stuff from Assassin's Creed 3 and 4, the ship combat and all that stuff, and putting it into this game. And I know a lot of people are upset that Unity might not have those things in there. A lot of people played Assassin's Creed 4 saying, I love the ship parts, but the rest of it can suck it. I mean, I wrote off the Assassin's Creed series a long time ago because they're just so repetitive. They take all the bad missions in Grand Theft Auto and make that the entire game. Just repetitive, 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 repetitive. The worlds are repetitive. The gameplay's repetitive. And apparently, I didn't play 4, but apparently the ship battles were the only thing that were good. So if you like the ship battles and you didn't want a game with ship battles for your brand new PS4, you can go back to the 360 and the PS3. One thing that I am glad to see out of this is that they are focusing Unity now on the next gen platforms. They probably have another team working on the last gen versions, so they're now separate and they don't have to be held back on the next gen versions by the previous generation's limitations. Now they can go all out on next gen and let that stuff be cash grab. If you like the games, congratulations, you have more of them. Assassin's Creed Rogue is coming out November 11th. Unity is coming out October 28th. It gives people a month to go, oh, I wish I had Unity. Look at Unity, it's so pretty. Oh well, I can get this one and be close. Anyways, yeah, I just wanted to let you guys know about some of the games that were coming out that were announced yesterday. Yay, stuff's happening in the game industry. The stories have been pretty slow lately. Please let me know in the comment section below if you guys are excited about Resident Evil getting an HD remake and another Assassin's Creed game. Oh, and Assassin's Creed was leaked too.